back everybody, I have another 12 by 12 layout for you, and this time round I am scrapping a photo of my mother-in-law and her visitors. This little birdie comes and visits her usually on an afternoon and sits on her veranda and has a little sticky beak. If you're not from Australia, these birds are called kookaburras and they are known for their laughter. They tend to always be laughing, or well, at least the sound that they make sounds like they're always laughing at you.
So back to the layout. My background paper is going to be the wood grain paper, and this paper is from Couture Creation, and it's from the Sunburnt Country collection, and it's paper 08A, and I will be using side B, which is that gorgeous wood grain paper. Then on the left hand side, I'm going to have this gorgeous blue paper, which is also from the Sunburnt collection, and it is paper 11A, and that blue side is actually side B again. I seem to like the side B's of these papers. And I trimmed that 11A paper to be 10 inches by 5.5. This paper here is going to run horizontal across my page, and it's paper 02A, also from the Sunburnt collection. This will be my layout number 3 for November for Aunty Vera's Scrap and Craft. And the theme for November was, I think she was an Aussie. So that's why you're seeing a lot of Australiana themed layouts lately. If you are looking for a group to join that is friendly and has a lot of fun, I would suggest you go to our Facebook page. It is Crafty Vera and Friends on Facebook, and join our group. It's very friendly. We have a few laughs and no one takes each other too seriously. So please pop on in. I will leave a link in the description box and come and join us and have some fun. I wanted my photos to pop off the page, so I'm doing what I usually do, and that is taking my perfect layers ruler and giving all my three photos a little bit of a border. I absolutely love this ruler because it gives my photos the absolute perfect border all around. So this one here is 1.6 millimeters. Then I decided that it needed something extra, so I went into my stash and I found this gorgeous paper that went so well with the waratahs that you'll see later, and that's going to give me my second mat for the photos. But I'm just going to gut the middle of the paper first because I decided that I also wanted to mat the whole layout and bring some more of that pink in. I must admit that it was pretty exciting to get this pink paper out of my stash and onto a layout, as it goes back to 2016. Not too old, because I have got papers that are about 10 years old, but at least it's out of my stash and finally been used. This is a very rare layout in the sense that I am actually documenting about birds. As anyone that knows me, I don't like birds, but I decided that my scrapbooking is all about moments that happen in our lives, and whenever we do visit, or the children visit their grandparents, this is what happens. And I wanted to document that moment that, you know, when we visit Granny, she gets these visitors, and the kids absolutely love the birds going onto the veranda and having a sticky beak and having a bit of a feed and all that. So I just wanted to capture these precious moments so that when the children look back on these layouts or through my albums, they go, oh, I remember that. That's Granny's little visitor that used to come by in the afternoons. And that is why you are going to see this very rare layout about kookaburras. I don't really pre-plan my layout, so I've decided that the horizontal piece of paper was just a little bit too long and I wanted more of the wood grain to show, so I'm just trimming it down. And then I went through my stash and I found these gorgeous wood veneers. And luckily I had two, so once I landed up pulling out the laugh, and so the title is going to be Laugh Kookaburra Laugh, because as I mentioned earlier, kookaburras seem to always be laughing, and you know, they seem to see the lighter side of things. So to me, even though I don't like birds, the kookaburras always do bring a smile to my face because they are just actually quite funny. It's just like someone's just cackling and you actually have to laugh and join in fun. I wanted to draw your eye more to the photo of Granny. So what I did was I went through my stash and I found this gorgeous washi tape, and I just put a strip down the top and a strip down the bottom, and I just thought that that looked really, really nice. So then in my stash I also found this tag, and it was the absolutely perfect colour. And all I'm going to do is use the tag for some journaling. So the journaling just reads, "These are visitors that arrive to visit Granny in the afternoon. Such happy creatures who are always laughing. Sometimes I think they just watch us humans and find us hilarious. I don't normally like birds, but kookaburras always tend to make me laugh." Next, I went looking for some more embellishments, and I found this lovely little tree. It was just a chipboard tree, and it's going to go on the bottom right-hand corner there. And I'm just cutting out this, or fussy cutting the little kookaburra. Now, the kookaburra is from the Couture Creations ephemera pack, also from the Sunburnt collection, and it was just a little bit too big as a stamp, so I'm just going to stick it down there. And the little tree, it's just chipboard, so I decided I wanted to add a bit more colour in it, to what I should say, and I'm just using some gesso so that I can brighten it up a little bit more. Putting my little tree aside to dry, and it's time for some fussy cutting. These gorgeous waratahs are also from the Sunburnt Country collection, and I landed up fussy cutting three. And if you look on the top right-hand corner, you will see some leaves. Those leaves are from the Couture Creations ephemera pack, a Sunburnt Country, and I also put a little waratah over the top. And back to my little tree. Now this little tree took the longest out of the whole layout, but I just wanted to get it right. So I played with some different products. I started off with Inca Gold in a, I can't believe what the colour's called, anyway, I have to look it up. And then that wasn't really good enough, so I went and I added some Colour Burst in Verde, and then I just kept playing with it. I remember adding some Prima Waxes and all sorts of things till I finally got something that I liked. So, little treat, time consuming, but I scrapbook to relax, and it's cheaper than therapy, so not complaining. And here are some close-ups. Thank you all so much for watching. I would love it if you hit that subscribe button if you're not already a subscriber, and hit the little bell for notifications. I tend to upload once a week, and that's about it for me. So thank you all for watching. Take care, and till next time. Bye, everybody.